Hello everyone, how are you today? 你们今天好吗? Alright, so today I would like to talk about an interesting topic with you, which is, do we really need to know how to differentiate Chinese tone in order to speak correctly? Okay, why I want to talk about this is because recently I have been asking my audience on my Instagram aboutwhat is your roadblock when it comes to Chinese learning? And a lot of them are saying, I found it very difficult for me to differentiate the tones. So I'm very afraid I was speaking wrong and I just stopped there and thinking, okay, so what tone is that word? Okay, so today I have a good news for you. The reality is you don't have to knowwhat tone exactly is that word in order to pronounce correctly. This is simple. I'm sure that you can sing a happy birthday song, right? 祝你生日快乐, this is in Chinese. Or you can say, you can sing in English, happy birthday to you, right? I'm sure everyone can sing that song. But do you ever think about what key are you singing?No, I don't think you would think about that, right? Nobody think about that, but you can sing it. So same as in Chinese, okay? Same as in Chinese. For the native speaker, first, we listen a lot. And we kind of like grab and pick up words by just listening, right? I'm sure it's the same for you because before go to school, you never learn.Like writing or thing, but you can say it correctly, right? Same as a Taiwanese, okay? For us, before go to school, we never learn what is tone. I don't even know what is tone, okay? Okay, so I never think like 我 is the third tone, 你 is the third tone, and 要 is the fourth tone. No, I never think about that. I just speak it naturally, right? I listen to my parents, my friends, my auntie, my uncle say many, many times, and I just pick it up. I know what that means. But I never knew what the exactly tone is that. So you don't have to do that, okay? Don't be too obsessed about the tone mark, okay?That's why I know why you're stuck there because you're thinking like, okay, first tone is high and now third tone is like going down and up. Like you, too many things running in your mind and there's actually a necessary process for you to be able to speak correctly, okay? So now I want to ask my friend. My friend,is not a Chinese teacher. I'm not asking any Chinese teacher here because many Chinese teachers, they're too professional and sometimes they forgot how they learn Chinese and how they speak Chinese, okay, in day-to-day life. So I'm gonna ask my friend if he ever think about what tone is that word for him to be able to speak, okay.
好哦,开始哦,好的,那第一个问题就是你说话的时候你会不会去想就是你讲话的那个字的声调是什么
你说平常说话吗
平常日常
其实日常的时候是不会去注重这件事情的
OK 所以你说话的时候像你现在说话你就不会去想说这是三声然后这二声这一声对不对
不会，绝对不会，完全不会。
好，好。现在有个问题，就是很多人会先在自己脑袋里面想说这个字是到底是几声，然后才敢讲。然后有时候他们不确定的时候就不敢讲，然后就导致他会卡在那边。对。
哦，我觉得可以建议他们是说，如果你是在正式场合的时候，就跟我们一样。你在正式场合的时候，我觉得你就特别去 care 这件事情。但是如果你就是哦，只是跟朋友一般的 conversation，那我觉得你就不用想那么多。就算你是对哦一般台湾人，就算对个便利商店的路人、老板娘也好，我觉得你不用去 care 这件事情，因为不会有人去纠正你，
对吧？
所以你就大胆的讲出来。那如果好，真的你因为你的声调错了，对方听不懂，我相信啊，他一定会直接会问说 “pardon” 之类的事。对，你在说什么之类的，对，那个时候你再矫正就好，你不用因为害怕而不去说，反而是你多就会。我觉得语言就是这样，
就是这样。 对，good good。
对对对对对。
好，那第二个问题就是说，就你小时候在学中文的学讲话的时候，然后你爸妈有告诉你说，就是这个字是几声，那个字是几声，这样吗？
在我印象中是完全没有。
对吗？而且
对啊。
你，因为我自己的经验是，一定是你是先听你爸妈怎么讲，然后你就直接 copy，对不
对啊，一定啊，一
对？对
定
啊，
啊，
就
因为
你不
都是
会
这样
去
子。
想那几声，因为那时候根本就还不知道什么叫声调，对不对？
不会，不会，不会。
然后还有最后一个就是，你是什么时候开始觉得，哦，你必须要真的知道这个中文字是什么声调？
考试的时候，
考试对不对？对，我就知道这个答案，对
就
吗？
是考试的，
对
就是
啊，
考试的时
就
候。
是为了考试的时候才需要那个。
我们学英文好像也会有一样的概念，对不对？
对啊，
我
好
们
像
自己
还
在
蛮……
学英文的时候，是啊，我们都很怕去发音什么东西的。
对，
但
发
其实一样，
错。
那些老外老师也是都说，你就发出来没
对
关
啊，
系，
对啊。
对吧？就算错了，不会有人怪你，因为你就不是那个语言的。
对啊，
人啊，
对啊，
对啊，你不是你，所以你发音错了，不会有人责备你，对
嗯
吧？你反而还可以从错误中学习，是一件很好的事情，
哼哼，真的是吼，
对吧？
太好啦，好，就是这样子，就没
可以，
了。
就可以帮助他们了。
对。
Yeah, so what I want to say is for be able to speak correct Chinese and pronounce well, you don't have to rely on the tone mark, okay? You don't need to wait them to tell you which tone to pronounce, but you just trust your ears and listen, 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 and you will pick it up the correct tone. After that, you will go back to maybe your textbook and see what tone is that. Gradually, you train your ear and you trust your ear, and then you match with the tone mark, and you know, okay, next time when you hear that sound, you know it should be a second tone. And how to train your ear is by listening. When it comes to pronunciation, my number one suggestion is listen a lot. Listen a lot. Trust your ear, okay? Too many people are not really listening the native how natives speak. They're just too obsessed by the textbook, the tone shows on the textbook. And they're just thinking, okay, I should go down a little bit. I should rise up a little bit here. No, okay. So again, just listen. By a lot of listening, you will definitely improve your pronunciation. Okay, right. So I'm not saying that tone mark is totally not useful and not important. Yes, if you want to join a test, you must know what tone is that character or that word. And if you want to type, you also need to know the correct tone, right? Okay, so as a native speaker, how do we do that? Okay, so after joining school, go to school, and we start to learn a Mandarin lesson. Of course, I'm sure you have your mother tongue language lesson. And in that lesson, teacher will give us vocabulary, and we have to kind of like force ourselves to remember what the character's tone is. Okay, so I should admit that I really need to admit that it's not that fun. But once you get a certain level, you kind of know when you hear that sound, you know what tone is that. So it's not like every single word you have to do, like force yourself to memorize them, okay? So it again is back to a lot of listening. So definitely give it a try and trust your ears. I have another video talking about how to improve your pronunciation. I'll link in the description box. All right, so if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up and remember to follow my Instagram on Cecilia Chen Chinese. Okay, so if you want to learn Mandarin from scratch, definitely check out my full course or free mini course in the description box. All right, so hope to see you there. Bye.